Hello and welcome to the Data Engineering Summit. My name is Irina Farooq and I'm one of the product leaders for our Smart Analytics portfolio. And joining me today is Prajakta Damle, the product lead for Dataplex. Welcome, Prajakta.
Thanks, Irina. It's great to be here.
Today, we're going to talk about how you can manage and govern your distributed data with Cloud Dataplex. We'll cover a little bit of an overview of Dataplex for some of you that are new, and then we have some exciting new announcements to share, and we'll close it off with a demo of the product to show you how you can do this yourself. So to set a little bit of a context, as we all know, enterprise data is distributed and will remain distributed across data warehouses, data lakes, databases. At the same time, the number of users in the organization that next need access to that data is growing exponentially, each one of these users bringing their own tools of choice and needing access to trusted, high-quality data within those tools. What this creates, because each of these systems comes with its own way to do metadata governance and data management, what this creates is an operational nightmare where customers are constantly building pipelines and building the glue to stitch the systems together. And the end result is that still only 16% of users trust the data that they see in their tools of choice. And this is exactly the problem that we've set out to address with Dataplex. Announced last year and available in general availability earlier this year in February, Dataplex is an intelligent data fabric that provides unified data management and governance, helping you manage your distributed data in a single place. With Dataplex, you can unify your data in the way that makes sense to your business and apply consistent policies, and which will then be propagated to the individual storage layers, irrespective of where data is stored. And then Dataplex provides the data intelligence capabilities to power data classification, sensitive data protection, give you the data quality and lineage, all with the end goal of building trust in your data and making the right data accessible to the end users and their tools of choice. Since Dataplex became generally available, we have been working with customers across a variety of industries, from financial institutions to digital natives to retailers, to help them build data mesh architectures and centrally manage and govern their data across the distributed footprint. At the same time, we've also been in the journey of learning with our customers of what we can do better and how we can further streamline this experience. And this is why we're very excited to announce today unification between Data Catalog and Dataplex. And some of you know, traditionally we've had Data Catalog, which surfaces the metadata to business users, and Dataplex to manage and govern your data. And now they're all unified together as a single product and as a single experience, providing you the end-to-end data visibility, management, and governance across your footprint. We think that this is pretty unique and differentiated in the industry, provides tremendous value to our customers, and at the same time provides an open and integrated platform where our partners can then extend the capabilities and customers themselves can extend the capabilities when a unified set of open APIs. As we always do, we've partnered closely with a variety of customers to get their feedback in the integration. And here you see a quote from Elton Martins from Loblaw sharing how they see the value in this integrated experience and having that single platform from discovering your data, managing your data, and governing your data in a single place. As you think about data management and governance, there's a full life cycle of capabilities that have to come together. And many of you went on board in different points, depending on where you are in the life cycle of building your data platform. But end-to-end, you're able to automatically discover all of your data, organize that data in a way that makes sense to your business, enrich it with business metadata, gain trust through lineage data quality, curate and secure that data, and ultimately have a central place to monitor and understand how your data is being used and who is using it. To make it just a little bit more concrete with a couple of use cases, for example, with now a central place through the discovery and data catalog, all of the data and metadata is automatically discovered and surfaced to the user with the right permissions and access control automatically enforced with that global search. So you can go find all of your data and then explore that data with a built-in exploration experience, whether in a notebook or a SQL Workbench interface. Now, as data stewards or data admins get visibility into all the data they have, they're able to centrally set permissions and policies across the distributed data that will be propagated through all the different storage layers and to the different tools that their users are using, whether ours or third party for an open ecosystem. And then at the same time, as many are looking to build a data mesh architecture, they're able to delegate the permissioning and some of the access management to their respective teams to build their data products that they can then make accessible to others within their organization. As we dig a little deeper, and we talked a lot about trust and making sure that the end users can ultimately trust the data in their tools of choice. And this is where we're heavily investing in data intelligence capabilities across the entire lifecycle, with data lineage and data quality being two such most prominent examples. So now with Dataplex, you automatically see data lineage for data in BigQuery, at the same time having a full set of open and extensible APIs where you can extend that with lineage information coming from other systems. That helps the users to understand the source of their end data, perform root cause analysis, and capture and understand the propagation of different data quality issues. At the same time, we're automatically scoring the data and providing data quality based on predefined rules so end users can get a clear indication of whether the data you're using they can actually trust. Hopefully by this point, you're just as excited as me about all of the capabilities in Dataplex. So I'd love to welcome Prajakta back here to give us a demo so you can see it in action yourself and get some ideas on how hopefully you can use it for yourself.
Thank you. So without further ado, let's just dive in and see some of these capabilities in action. Imagine you are on the data team of a bank, and we'll call that Mars Bank. And Mars Bank has many different lines of businesses. They have the commercial banking, retail banking, fraud detection, fraud management, and so on and so forth. Today, we are going to look at their data landscape, specifically in their retail banking section. And Mars Bank stores their data in GCS, Google Cloud Storage, and in BigQuery. So let's take a look at how Dataplex can enable this bank to organize their data, so this is their physical data, into meaningful business domains. So with Dataplex, a customer like Mars Bank can create multiple logical domains. Here you have a customer domain, and then within that domain, they can create zones to segment the data based on the readiness of the data or the use of that data. So they can create raw zone, a curated zone, as well as expose well-curated data products to their consumers using a data product zone. And not only can they do that for one domain, they can have multiple such domains with delegated ownership while still having centralized governance and management across their data landscape. So now let's take a look at some of these concepts live. So here on my screen is the Dataplex console. And I'm going to start by first walking through what a typical analyst would do in order to find the data that they're looking for. So here in the search experience in Dataplex, an analyst can come in and search for the data that they're looking for based on a domain. So here I'm searching for the customer domain. They can find the tables that map to that domain, regardless of where the data for those tables is stored. And then they can easily click into a table and look at the details of that table. So they can look at where that data is stored. So here, this table maps to a table in BigQuery, the schema of that table, as well as tags that have been automatically populated based on the tags that a data steward has set up. So here, if you see, there are four different tags that have been associated with this table, and the values have been automatically propagated. So here you can see data quality score being populated for this table. So as an analyst, I have a great idea of what is the data that I'm using and whether I can trust the data that I'm using. And if I want, I can actually click here and look at a more in-depth data quality dashboard and dive deeper into some of these data quality metrics. Now, how does this come about, or how does this get set up? So now let's go back to our Dataplex UI and look at what a typical journey would look like for a data steward. So as a data steward, I can come into Dataplex and set up tag templates that then can be used by data owners in various different domain teams to tag the data appropriately and then provide more meaningful context to the data consumers as they use that data. So here for Mars Bank, we have four different data templates set up for quality, for how the data is shared on an exchange, for data classification, and to provide additional information about the ownership of that data. And here is another example of the template where, for data classification, as a steward, you can actually go ahead and create a template that indicates what data is sensitive and how the description of that data and how do you want that data to be tagged and accessed. Now, in Dataplex, the search is governed search. So only the data that an individual has access to is made available through a global search so that you can be sure that as an analyst, as a data steward, or as a data owner, you can have the right access not only to data, but also to metadata. So now, once the data steward has set up these tag templates, a data owner can actually go into the manage section of Dataplex and set up appropriate domains. These domains are logical domains and that map to the business context that is more meaningful to you in your organization. So in this case, we have the customer domain, merchant domain, and so on and so forth. So let's dive into the customer domain. And then within the customer domain, I have a raw zone, a curated zone, and a data product zone. So if I take a look at the raw zone, I have my raw data stored in a cloud GCS or Google Cloud Storage bucket. And this data is automatically discovered and cataloged. So to see what data is automatically discovered, I'm going to switch over to a different tab and go back to my search interface. So here you can see that for this raw zone, I have two tables that have been automatically discovered. So if I look at the customer data table from the raw zone, this maps to data in GCS. It is of format CSV, and it is available for data exploration in BigQuery. You can also start curating this data from the same same experience and have built-in templates to curate this data from a CSV to a more curated data format. So if I now go ahead and open it in BigQuery, the same table is available in BigQuery for your analysts to start using this data in their analysis, in their reporting, in their dashboards. So switching back to the Dataplex UI, once I have my data organized and cataloged, I also have a way to centrally secure this data. So I can add my central access control policies based on the data domains that I have set up. And I can add those policies at the customer domain level. And these policies are then inherited by all the zones within this domain and all the assets that have been added to this domain. And Dataplex actually propagates these policies to the underlying storage layer so that the access control is enforced from an end-to-end perspective. So here I have different service accounts with different permissions added at this domain level. And then these permissions are inherited by the zones as well as by the individual assets. I can also use this UI to look at the various principles within Dataplex and get a more principle-centric view, where I can click on a given principle and look at the permissions that that principle has on different domains and assets within Dataplex. So here I can see that this merchant service account has permissions to the merchant source domain. Once you have set up your domains and you have applied your access control policies centrally, Dataplex also provides you a number of different tasks to curate your data and process your data. So here I have a number of tasks that have already been set up for curating raw data into curated formats and then making those available as data products to many of your consumers. And we have these built-in templates that run on Dataflow. You can also run your data quality checks, and the results of which we saw earlier in the demo. And if you have some custom tasks, you can actually run custom Dataproc serverless tasks through Dataplex, and then have all of these tasks orchestrated centrally through Composer with the Dataplex operator that we have already made available in Composer. So with Dataplex, we want to provide a central data management and governance layer that is well integrated with our portfolio of products so that you can leverage the context of the metadata that we have curated within various products, as well as use different tools to achieve the tasks that you need to perform to manage your data centrally. So one of the key capabilities of Dataplex that we have recently introduced is data lineage. So I want to go back to the search interface and show you how the customer data has automatically captured lineage. So if I look for my customer's data table and I click on that table, I can click on the lineage tab to see what are the downstream dependencies, what tables have been derived from the customer data table. So here is the customer data table, that's the raw table that was automatically discovered and registered in BigQuery, but that table has been used as a source for four different tables to create more curated tables and curated data, which can then be traced from this lineage graph. The lineage graph essentially helps you track the end-to-end dependencies of your data, and that's built into the search or the metadata view within Dataplex itself. And then finally, in addition to exploring your data in BigQuery, we also have a Spark SQL workbench built into Dataplex where you can come in and explore the data that is within different domains, either using Spark SQL scripts or notebooks. And this runs on an entirely managed serverless interactive Spark SQL workbench within Dataplex. So that's all I have in terms of demo today, folks. So I'm going to hand it back to Irina to wrap this up.
Thank you so much, Prajakta. And thank you all for joining and staying with us till the end. I hope you're just as excited as I am about all the different capabilities. And please feel free to continue the conversation with us online or use these additional resources like white papers and product details to help you get started with Dataplex. Thank you again, and we'll see you soon. Bye.